Another factor we need to discuss in discussing the nervous system and these organs we call nerves are the 12 cranial nerves. Now notice that I have here listed in Roman numerals, which is how they're usually shown, Roman numeral 1, 2, all the way through 12 here, and then the cranial nerve named after it. Now the reason why these are in this specific order, and you will always see them in this specific order, is because when we look at the brain, cranial nerve number 1 actually is the olfactory nerve, and it is on the base or the frontal area of the frontal lobe, this lower area of the frontal lobe. Cranial nerve number 2 is down here, 3 is further down, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 then would be the lowest of the cranial nerves, so they're extending from basically the frontal lobe all the way down to the medulla oblongata, and they basically connect in the order that we give them. So 1 is here, 2 is here, 12 would be down here, and everything in between would be in the order that the number that the Roman numeral is. So just looking at them, olfactory, which gives us our sense of smell, optic, which sends the visual pathways to the brain to be interpreted, oculomotor, which means eye movement, oculo, eye, motor, movement, trochlear, which is also eye movements, trigeminal, the scalp, face, and teeth, and chewing movements, abducens, eye movements. Notice we actually have 3 different cranial nerves that deal with eye movements, and we have different, when we look at our eyes, we'll notice that we have 3 different pairs of muscles on our eyes that move our eyes in different directions. So these cranial nerves are controlling those. Facial, taste and contraction of skeletal muscles in the face region. Vestibulocochlear, our hearing, the cochlear portion of the vestibulo gives us our sense of balance. That's cranial nerve number 8. Glossopharyngeal, which glosso basically means tongue, pharyngeal means throat, so this gives us the sensations in our throat and tongue area. Vagus nerve, which extends way down and makes up a big part of that parasympathetic nervous system. Accessory, cranial nerve 11, which shoulder movements and certain movements of the head. And hypoglossal means hypo below, glossal tongue. Now, what is this crazy looking thing over here that I have? And this is kind of a little bit of a drawing to help us remember where each of these are. So as you're learning this, and there are different little sayings. I learned one that said, on old Olympus towering tops, a friendly Viking grew vines and hops. And learned that saying using just the first letter of each of the different cranial nerves. So say that faster. On old Olympus towering tops, a friendly Viking grew vines and hops. If you come up with a little mnemonic, it helps you keep them in order. But what this picture does, if you'll notice, cranial nerve number 1 had to do with olfactory. So I look in the picture for number 1. I see number 1 kind of in the nose region. So the nose is kind of what we think of as where we get our sense of smell from. So olfactory, sense of smell. Number 2, optic. So notice I have in the eye region the optic, or a number 2, representing the optic or for vision. Number 3, oculomotor, eye movement. So it's still kind of in the eye region, in this case making like little eyebrows. We have 2 little 3s here showing that that is oculomotor or eye movements. 4, trochlear or eye movements. We also made some little glasses around number 2 and near number 3. So these also help us control some of the muscles in our eyes. Okay, number 5, the trigeminal. Okay, now notice here's my number 5 right here. And notice that here we have sensations of the face, scalp, and teeth chewing movements. So face, scalp, teeth, and chewing movements. We kind of made a mouth out of that portion of the 5. All right, number 6, abducens, eye movements. So again, there's another one in the eye area. just kind of made a circle around the two with, but that's a six. If you'll notice, that's the number six. So look at the cranial nerves dealing with the eyes. Two, three, four, and six. One dealt with smell. Five deals with face, scalp, mouth, and chewing movements, teeth area. Okay. Number seven, facial. Notice we outlined the face with this seven right here and then made a backward seven just to have another portion of the face. Eight, vestibulocochlear. So cochlear was hearing, so we put our eights out here where our hearing or ears would be. And then, of course, the vestibulo means that vestibular area we talked about that sends the information primarily to our cerebellum and helps us understand and have balance. Okay, glossopharyngeal, which is number nine. So number nine, glosso, here's the tongue. So glosso means part of the tongue, but pharyngeal means the throat. So behind the tongue is the throat area. So we put our nine here where it's kind of partially on the tongue, but back where the throat would be in relationship to the mouth. 10, vagus nerve. Now this is our longest nerve that goes to the most things. So it actually extends way down into our body. So that's why we have this kind of running down through here and extending out. This again is really what controls the majority of our parasympathetic nervous system, restoring us back to a rest and digestive state of the autonomic nervous system. 11, accessory, with shoulder movements, movements of the head. Notice if this is my head here, I've got this 11 right here and here, kind of being out towards the shoulder, but also towards the head. And then hypoglossal means tongue movement. So I drew my tongue here. Hypo means below, and glossal means tongue. So this is kind of the lower portion below the tongue area. All right, so this silly little thing, if you can kind of draw it as you're learning these, it'll actually help you remember where these things are.